I just stopped by Long Beach tonight to say to you that what will happen to the Martin Luther King Jr. Center of Long Beach if you don't stop and attend to it and pay attention to it.
All right.
And give it what it needs so that it can continue to live and thrive and prosper and those dreams that are inside of those young people can come alive and they can begin to fulfill their Christ.
All right.
And I'm not getting ready to deliver a sermon, but I just want to lift this story and glean from it on tonight. And then I'm going to take my seat. There's a story in the Bible about a man that was traveling down this curvaceous and very dangerous road called Jericho.
All right.
And in the story, there are some individuals who end up accosting him, and they end up stripping him of his raiment, and they end up beating him and leaving him on the side of the road bloody and hoping that he will die. And the story goes on to say that there was this priest that happened to come by that location, but the priest, instead of stopping, just passed on by.
Yes, he did. Yes.
It goes on to say that there was, in like fashion, a Levite, who also came across that same location where this person was on the side of the road, but he passed by as well.
Well,
but then the story captures this individual called a Samaritan. And this Samaritan came to that same particular spot, but instead of passing on by, he decided to get up a little bit close and ended up beginning to help this person on the side of the road. He disembarked his animal and he picked a gentleman up from the side of the road and placed him on his animal, and they began to travel down that Jericho road to an inn. And he checked the gentleman into a room in that inn. And we're told that he didn't just leave. He decided that he was going to stay a little bit to nurse the gentleman, and so he decided to stay overnight. And the story goes on to say that he went to the innkeeper the next day and said, look, I'm leaving the funds to cover his stay. And when I return, if it's a little bit more, I will make up the difference. Why do I lift this story? I lift this story because oftentimes when people see situations like the man that's on the side of the road, the first question that most people ask is, what's going to happen to me if I stop and try to help this particular situation, particularly when there's trouble? And that courage really came from a determination to want to make sure that this man had a chance to continue his life. It's going to take courage to keep the dream of the Martin Luther King Jr. Center alive. Why is it going to take courage? Because anytime you are involved in an endeavor to help and change and transform lives, there are always adversarial circumstances. There are always challenges. There are always contentions that try to come against you. And it takes courage and strength to be able to withstand that stuff. It takes courage to keep your head straight and focused when people may misunderstand. It takes courage when people may persecute you and malign you and criticize you. It takes courage. It takes courage to be able to face very difficult circumstances. In order to win, they knew that it would take a lot of muscle for them to win. But it also took courage. It takes courage to get up again when you've gone through a defeat. It It takes courage whenever you come under some kind of attack. It takes courage. It took courage for this gentleman to risk his life on that Jericho road to help this man, because I understand that road is rather curvaceous, and those who attacked him and bloodied him. Warriors had some things in common. There's just a few things I'm going to lift, because there are probably several that I could. But in the first place, they had a thing called courage and strength. Courage and strength. They had courage and they had strength. In the first place, I want to talk about my strength, because the warriors could have very well taken a different kind of attitude and approach when they lost on last year. They could have gotten discouraged, but it took a different kind of mindset to be able to push through and ensure that they would end up again in the finals, so that they could win the championship game. They had a strength of determination. They had a strength of heart. It also takes sacrifice. If this dream is going to stay alive, James Hodge and the few that are there are not enough.
Well,
it takes sacrifice. And when I talk about sacrifice, I'm talking about more than just financial contributions. Tonight is great, and I want to applaud everyone who in any form and fashion supported this dinner. But brothers and sisters, it's got to go beyond tonight. We got to go into sacrifice is when you give to the point where it hurts a little bit. Where you got to give something up that you normally would not give up. It's when you interrupt your life and your schedule and even your pocketbook to ensure that something continues. And so I'm making an appeal tonight to everyone in this room, because being here tonight is one step, but the second step is to consider, what is it that I can sacrifice, not just on one occasion, but on a consistent basis, to make sure that this particular center continues, that make sure it has what it needs, because the deception is that it's been here for as long as it's been here, so it's going to be here just as long. But that's not a guarantee.
Oh, no.
There's trouble in the camp.
Oh, yeah, they're working on it. They're working on it.
Help is needed. Resources are needed in terms of human resources. I was there last night and I saw these wonderful iMac computers, and applause to the people who donated them so that these kids can begin to develop their skills. We're talking about developing STEM. And that's so important in today's society if our young people are going to be able to make it and be successful and be prosperous. But they're going to need help. So that it can become a reality. Somebody's got to be there to make sure that they're teaching them how to function. They need to have people who are giving their time to teach them even how to code. Help.
You're talking.
And I'm going to say something